G'day everybody, welcome, and thank you for coming along on this Let's Play Timberborn journey. I haven't played this game since it first got released. I played it for a bit and then stopped. It's multiple updates now, it's time to revisit, relearn, see where we go. Start with the plains. I won't start with hard. If I was more practiced at the game, I'd go into hard, but I'm not, so we'll start with normal. What do we want to call it? Beaverville. That'll work. Okay. All of our little beavers running out. So the blue area sort of highlights where he'll go. So I suppose we want to encapsulate as much as we can. So we'll stick him there. The beaver's moving. Doing his little hand gestures. I wanted me to place two, but I don't. Need to. Create paths in this game, otherwise it... So this, very much like Settlers, the old school Settlers, in that you must connect the buildings, you must connect them. Nothing to do in range, what do you want about this? Frickin' trees right there! Nothing to do in range. What a... Hang up. Hold the bus. Aha. Yes. We gotta select trees to cut down. So, we shall select trees to cut down. Okay. Oh, trees for cutting. Build a water pump. Here we go. If I recall right, you really want water pumps sort of in areas like this. And you want to put like a floodgate in there, but we're not up to that yet, so we'll get to that. Put the water pump there. Connect a road. Carting his wood over. Okay. you want. Very cool. We want to have as much green as you can, which means you've got to get the water going where you can without flooding this. So sort of further down the game, you'd build a wall sort of around, maybe 2, 3, 4 tiles high, whatever, and then build a dam across here, which would then flood inland and come out the other side, which would green up all of this, which then makes it useful. Not all of that, all of this, which makes it useful in terms of being able to build there. Speed things up a bit. Don't think, if I recall right, they don't work at night. So they only work during the day. So yeah, they're all having a little snooze. There it is, there we've got the water pump. Water pump is built. Build a gather a flag. Come on, gather food, gather. Gather a flag, okay. Over here, and we wanna build an efficient farmhouse. Okay. What do they do? Employees? Farmers that plant and harvest crops. The expanded forked out design fits more workers. Gatherers, carrots, flowers, sun seeds, potatoes, and wheat. Okay. Well, we'll build it. We'll build it and see what's what. See the little water icon above their heads, means they were getting thirsty, so they ran to the pump house, get a drink to carry on, and they'll go have a snooze, should all lay down. So they have like a period of night where they, when you get later on into the game, where they entertain themselves and they just have a snooze. See, just have a little snooze where they are. When you build houses, they'll eventually go home. They're back in action. And they'll finish building that farmhouse shortly, I would think. Okay. Farmhouse is built. Plant carrots. Plant carrots. You need fertile ground for planting. Large pile. Okay. Actually, we might stick him there. We'll stick him there. And large pile. Set large pile to logs. Built a small tank. Set small tank to water. Small tank. Small house. That's a small tank. To build those two. We need three small tanks. Build them around the place, I think. Three tanks, I just got to finish building the three tanks, and then you should get a dude that just runs and fills them up with water. I spaced them out like that. It's been a while, so my knowledge of the efficiency of this game is just means they've got less, one person's got further run to fill up the tank, but the workers have less distance to run to quench their thirst. So okay, we'll bump the speed. So yeah, they're thirsty and they got to run to the tank, the pump. We don't want them running to the pump. Now to snooze again. Tells you who's doing what. So I've got 10 adults, 2 kids. Everyone's asleep. Most are working, and one is not. I'm not sure how to fix that. You need employment for him, so I don't have any yet. See how he fills the tanks. Still hasn't done this one because it's probably too far away. So okay, there's gonna go to snooze town. Build a medium warehouse. Can set warehouses on top of each other. Carrots, berries, but you do still need to connect a path. So I don't have stairs yet, which is a problem. So I need to scrap that. This, and put him back on the base level. But yes, when the time comes, you can stack your warehouses and use stairs and stuff. It's coming into daylight, we'll soldier on. The housing now. need 6 lodges, so... There's a lodge. Homes. Again, you can stack these once you get to that point. The tutorial does sort of slow walk you, but if I recall right, you want to beeline towards getting dams and walls and stuff, because the season changes and the water disappears, and you want to retain as much water as you can. So, you know, you build like a dam down here with a spillway just to keep as much water as you possibly can. Anywhere where there's high points like that, that is a perfect spot for a dam. Again, up and up and up and up and up. So you can have like a three gorges kind of thing. You want to retain as much water as you can in the high spots. Got happy beavers, yay! If they demolish that, it should let the water in, which should green up a bit more of the area. Getting to the point where we start unlocking the who's-its and the what's-a-ma-calls-its. I'll go to sleepy time, so they should all... You can build entertainment districts at some point, which is all a good thing, and they will entertain themselves and then go to sleep. See, they should all go into their homes. There's a couple still without homes. Oh no, there they go. You can also affect flow and stuff with walls and stuff, so you can create a high flow area of the river to give you more power, which is good. Multiple ones, and yeah, If I recall right, it was pretty in-depth, and as far as I'm aware, with the multiple updates that have come out, it has become even more in-depth, which is a good thing. And they're cranking out. So yeah, this tank's full. That tank's getting there. That tank's still got nothing. So if I had another pump, yeah, they'd fill up faster. Goals, folks. We're kicking goals everywhere. Just assumes because we don't have enough. Period. So they just don't bother, really. Dark stuff is what's been harvested. Lighter stuff is to be harvested. The berries, I think, show up as blue when the time comes. Okay, got a lumber mill, and well, we got the freaking water wheel going, and now we're going to build a lumber mill. Stick it there. And we've got to power it, so we're going to run some pipes. Bet I can't fit a wheel in. Okay. So because I couldn't build the platform, couldn't reach the wheel, yada yada yada. So the reason I want one in the middle, you can see the flow, and it's stronger towards the middle than it is, sorry, the current is stronger towards the middle than it is towards the edge. Like, it's getting current, but not as good. Okay, so they are putting stuff in there when they need to. Still just waiting for this power wheel and power line. What do they call it? Do they call it a power line? I think they do. They call it power shaft. Power shaft. Yeah. For the power shaft to be completed after the power wheel has been smashed out. I reckon we get rid of that one. And we build another one. Closer. Right, power wheel's finished. Power shaft is finished. The lumber mill is getting power. Good. Now we need to build a forester. He plants trees and bushes. We want to place him well. As well as we can. Do we want to stick him down here? Maybe we stick him down here. No, that's not good. Stick him there. Stick him there and run a road. So I wonder which is the most efficient trees to plant. So maples have the highest yield per turn, some people were saying, but it doesn't look like they do per square. Seems the general consensus is you plant a little patch of pine and then maple out the rest. Once that's finished, it should plant some pine. Then we'll go ahead and plant a bunch of maple. That should keep us instead for a while. Having just come across from Land of the Vikings, much more don't even need that, so I'll get rid of that. Much more honed and finished product, even though it's still, I believe Timberborn's still in early access, but I'm not sure. Actually it is, yes, because when I started up the game it said it was in early access, so yeah. That doesn't need to be up there anymore. It's just not worth it. It needs to be there. Leaves behind rubble, so that's good. You get to reclaim some of your materials. Broken teeth. No. I don't know what you do about that. Broken teeth is no good. Forest is completed. We planted the pine. Boom. Tutorial's over. It's all on us from now. So, I think that's a good opportunity to call it there, guys. I'll see you on the next one, where we carry on our journey. Catch us later.